Hi! Today I'm going to talk to you about all of my discontinued perfumes. Discontinued perfumes can be a little bit of a heartbreak when you find out that a perfume you love has been discontinued, or if you try a perfume specifically because it's discontinued, that can be such a heartbreak if you fall in love with it. That has happened to me quite a few times. And I use the Fragrantica user compiled list, which I will link in the description box below, to help me figure out if a perfume is discontinued or not, and all of these perfumes are on that list. Discontinued doesn't necessarily mean hard to find yet. It just means that the company is no longer producing this perfume, but there may still be stock available. I'll try to mention if I know that there's stock available about the perfumes that I mentioned, but like I said, it can be a little bit of a heartbreak if you fall in love with it, because eventually you will run out. There will be no more bottles to buy. The newest addition to my collection is a older version of Dior Addict. Dior Addict was released in 2002 and has undergone quite a few reformulations in its time, in its short life. And this is from 2010, and this version, the liquid inside, is no longer available. It's been reformulated, so there is a new formulation of Dior Addict that is currently available. It has a different style bottle, and it doesn't smell exactly the same. It smells very similar, but it is missing a little bit of the earthiness and complexity that this version has. I really, really like this version. I also really like the current version. So I don't really know that you're missing out necessarily. I think if you really love the current formulation of Dior Addict, it might be worth it to try and find even just a decant of the vintage version or the older reformulations, just to try. And it's, I don't know, I feel like smelling this version helped me appreciate the current version a little bit more, but that's my first one. Another perfume that hasn't really been reformulated, but it's been re-released as a different perfume, is Mon Exclusif from Guerlain, and this has basically been re-released as Mon Guerlain. There have been some changes in the formula, but essentially they're the same, and I don't really know if I would be able to tell the difference on somebody else wearing this, which one was which. But the bottle is so beautiful. It looks like a little bow, and I love everything about this. And I don't tend to wear this often because I have Mon Guerlain and they are so similar. I think if I smell them side by side, I prefer this one, but just in general, I can't really tell the difference. But unfortunately, this is no longer made. I do believe this is still available online. So if I can find a link for it, I will leave it below. My very first discontinued perfume heartbreak was with Penhaligon's Ostara. This is a beautiful Narcissus perfume. It is soft and floral and spicy, and I love wearing this in the springtime, but I smelled this because it was discontinued, and I don't know why I did that to myself, but I found out this was being discontinued. I owned no Penhaligon's. I hadn't even smelled any Penhaligon's perfumes, and I got such a good deal. This was on their website for like $40 or something, which is an insane price for a Penhaligon, and oh my god, I love daffodils. Daffodils are my absolute favorite flower. And so when I saw the Narcissus perfume, I was like, well, of course I'm going to love it. And it's yellow, which is my favorite color. So I just knew this was going to be for me. And stupid me, I only bought a 50 ml bottle and I only bought one. I should have bought more. But I really love this perfume. It just smells like spring. And I love wearing this on the first day of spring, and I love wearing it like on Easter, and I just really think Penhaligon's, you shouldn't have discontinued it. So I do tend to like sparingly wear this, and luckily it's a very strong perfume, so I get quite a lot out of few sprays. Another perfume that I bought because it was discontinued is Shalimar Parfum Initial. And I've spoken about this perfume before. And to me, it smells like a librarian, like a sexy librarian. It is so beautiful. And this is another one that I use fairly sparingly because I love it so much and I'm so sad that it's discontinued. It's just really pretty, soft, powdery, feminine, a little lemony, a tiny little bit smoky, very dusty, powdery, a little cold. I feel like there's like a tea kind of vibe. I always imagine drinking tea when I smell this, but it is so beautiful and just really unique. I'm really sad that this is discontinued and that this is all I have. If I had a backup bottle, I would definitely wear this more often because it makes me feel good to wear it. This next perfume I bought because I adored the bottle and I fell in love with the scent right at the time they discontinued it. And it's Cartier Beiser Volet Essence de Parfum. And this is a really beautiful lily and vanilla fragrance. And to me, it's got a bit of a suntan vibe to it. But oh, it's just this sweet, soft, lush green lily. And the vanilla in it really kind of tempers the greenness, like the sharpness of the green, like the stem. And it just smells very edible. Like I just want to take a bite out of it, but it's so soft, very perfect for spring and summer. I absolutely adore this in any weather. And it's so feminine and very polished, very just feminine. Speaking of lily, I was able to find a decant of Tom Ford's Shanghai Lily. And this, oh my God, the color of this is so gorgeous. It's like this pinky, corally color. I don't know if against my turquoise wall, this color is really coming out the way it looks in real life, but this is so gorgeous. This is a lot of that sweet, lush lily, but with a lot of spices on top of it. And oh, this one I had never smelled before. I just really like lily, and so I wanted to give this a shot. What disappoints me about this perfume is that the lily does not last as long as I would like. It really quickly turns to just spices, but it's perfect for the winter. I think it's a very cozy scent. And I might actually try layering this with the Beiser Volet because I think that might make the lily last a little bit longer. I'm gonna have to give that a shot. But anyway, I was so happy to find this decant because I can't find bottles of it anywhere and they would be prohibitively expensive if I could. But yeah, Shanghai Lily from Tom Ford, very good. This next perfume is the only celebrity perfume on this list because I kind of forget that it's a celebrity perfume. Madonna's Truth or Dare is stunning. It is so beautiful, so sexy, so buttery and creamy. This is a beautiful tuberose fragrance. I've been told that it smells a lot like Fracas, which I have never smelled, but now I really want to because I love this one and this is discontinued. I actually had a bigger bottle of this that I swapped because I'm stupid. And then when I found out it was discontinued, I had to find another bottle, and the smaller one is the only one I could get my hands on. But I really, really, really like this fragrance. This fragrance too, I think works in many different seasons. And like I said, it is very sexy without being, it isn't like a spicy, heavy, like in your face kind of sexy. It's a very subdued, pulled back, refined sexy. This is definitely a like, ooh, I got close to her and she smelled good kind of scent, versus she walked in the room and she smelled good. Those are some of my discontinued perfumes. I would love to hear if there are any discontinued perfumes that you love, maybe that you're heartbroken about that you can't find anymore. Anyway, thank you so much for watching.